Magandang umaga mga Lodi. Ray Kuturuman po mga kaibigan, sinabi na ang new breed ng Gilas Pilipinas ay mas kaya pang higitan ang achievement ng kanyang kupunan na hinawakan dati. Sinabi pa nga mga kaibigan ni Chris Chu ang dating manlalaro na ang pagkatalo sa South Korea ay isa sa mga pinakamasakit na pagkatalo na na-experience niya bilang manlalaro. Despite the last-minute inclusion of PBA players like Jimmy Lapag, Kelly Williams, and Ranidel De Ocampo to beef up the amateur-laden Smart Gilas team noon, the Filipinos were not able to get past the Koreans in the battle for bronze medal 10 years ago. Sabi pa nga ni Chris Chu, when we lost in the battle for third against Korea, that was really painful because that was the ultimate tournament that we were preparing for the entire 3 years. Masakit nga yun, mga kaibigan. To try to win and make it to the Olympics. That was our goal, ika nga ni Chu. For the team and our country, we were so close. Even if we were out of the running because it's a battle for third na lang, we knew we had them. We were in control of the game for 38 minutes and in the last 2 minutes, mga kaibigan, we were up by 8 and they got hot. And the rest is history, ika nga. Things didn't go our way. Even the calls didn't go our way. Nakaka-frustrate talaga. We lost the game and it was painful experience. It was a painful experience for all of us. Pero sinabi naman ni Toroman, mga kaibigan, na naniniwala siya. He believes that the lack of time before of players like Jimmy Alapan, Williams, Kelly Williams, and De Ocampo ay nagkaroon ng impact in terms of team chemistry. Kung matatandaan ang tropang Bexers before ay maglalaro vying for a grand slam and yung tatlong manlalarong ito ay nakapag-join lamang or nakasali lamang sa kanila ilang araw before the FIBA Asia Championship. Isa ito sa mga dahilan kung bakit nagkaroon ng problema sa team chemistry. Dagdag pa ni Raiko Toroman, looking at the program ng bagong Gilas Pilipinas, Toroman sees the latest version of Gilas as much better compared to the ones he handled before. Ang kagandahan nito na meron tayo ngayon na wala noon ay ang size. According to the Serbian mentor, who now serves as the head coach of the Indonesian men's basketball team, the biggest asset of the latest version of Gilas Pilipinas is their size. The new Gilas is the tallest ever national team assembled. Mantakinyo, 7'3 Kai Soto, 6'10 Angelo Kwame, 6'9 Gio Chu, 6'8 Justin Baltazar, 6'7 Isaac Go, and Carl Tamayo as well. At isang 6'6 William Navarro alternating up the front. Mantakin yung frontline ng ating bagong Gilas Pilipinas. And also, hindi lamang yun, ang ating team ay nagkaroon din ng isang versatile na guard at forward in the name or in the likes of Dwight Ramos, kaibigan. Which according to Tab Baldwin ay nakikita niya ng isang potential. Ika nga niya, he is looking like a European player. So that's how impressive, that was how impressive this new Gilas team was in the eyes of an old coach who follows, who sees the importance of long preparation like Raiko Toroman. Toroman was honest to admit that the latest version of Gilas Pilipinas can surpass the team that he coached more than a decade ago in terms of achievement. Yun ang sinabi niya. For sure, these players are very talented. For me, they're at the level of PBA players. They have size, they can make it difficult. That makes it difficult for anybody. They have Kai Soto. now they've been getting some experience, some exposure in international games. It will be good for the Philippines. Mga kaibigan, the future is now for Philippine basketball. So, antabayanan ang mga susunod nating mga videos sa paghimay-himay natin sa ating Gilas Pilipinas. Maraming salamat po. Don't forget to click the button below, comment, and subscribe. Thank you.